Show us your glory. Show us your glory. Show us your glory. Let every burning heart be wholly grand.
Thank you, Father God.
Just worship for a few more minutes. Just in your own way, tell Jesus how you love him. That you're thankful for what he's done in your life. I'm telling you, in this moment, it's a game changer. Some of you need breakthrough right now. Some of you need divine breakthrough in your life right now. There's breakthrough in the house. Hallelujah. There's breakthrough in the house. There's breakthrough in the house. There's breakthrough. Come on, if you're not lifting your hands, pray for somebody else around that needs breakthrough. If you're not used to this morning, this is what a move of the Holy Spirit looks like. We at this church allow the Holy Spirit to move. We worship you, Lord. It's not like you, Lord. We tried it every other way, but your way is the best, Lord. Your presence is fullness of joy. Some of you had joy in a long time. I believe the joy of the Lord is your strength here today. Some of you haven't laughed in a long time, but God's about to give you a dose of medicine. Come on, he's in this house. Just a few more minutes. I'm not going to preach until he tells me to. Hallelujah. Come on, there's some breakthrough here today. This is breakthrough. This is breakthrough. Come on, help me pray today. Help me pray. Hallelujah. About you, but if you need prayer, I'd get down here right now. I'm telling you, there's an anointing here. It's all right. It's all right if you need prayer. Come on. We don't have to wait until the end of service to receive. Come on. If you're not being prayed for, pray for somebody else. There's some people that need breakthrough in the house today. There's some people that need healing. I don't know about you, but if I need anything from God, I would get up into this anointing right now. I'm telling you, it's an anointing that breaks every yoke of bondage. I wouldn't care what my mother said, my friend said, or what anybody else looked like. I would step out by faith. I'm going to tell you, it takes the faith of a mustard seed. I'm going to tell you something. There's been some kids even praying for you. My kids this week have been praying for a move of God. Mama might be down, but I tell you, if you have some childlike faith today, God can do the impossible. I want some people that are servants here today that know how to pray to help me pray today. We're just going to see the Lord move right now in Jesus' name. Shut up. on, keep praying, keep on praying, keep on praying, keep on praying, keep on praying. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
today. If you're not used to this, this is because this is scriptural. I believe we're living in a day and time that we're afraid to allow the Holy Spirit to move. The Bible talks about signs and wonders, but what you experience today is a true, genuine move of the Lord. I could preach, I could teach. I don't believe that's what the Lord wants me to do right now. Because I believe God has accomplished everything He wants to do in this minute. But I want us to take about 5 minutes. Just 5 minutes. I've prayed for a lot of people, but I want us to pray for our city. I want us to pray for the surrounding areas because God is sending people. I'm telling you, we may be living in a crazy generation, but there are people looking for a move of God. I'm telling you, they are. They're looking. And I may be a little bit different, but how many of you know Jesus was very different? But I want you to bind with somebody today. Let's find somebody. Let's find somebody. You reach out to your neighbor, the person next to you. But we're going to spend about 5 minutes. We're going to pray for souls. We're not going to be called Harvest Center and not pray for people, right? A good name is carefully chosen over riches. So I want you to come on, participate. I know God's been moving. And we're going to pray for souls. There's some grandchildren. There's kids in your own life. And I believe there's people in each of your lives. We could fill this place up three times with the amount of people that we're connected with that don't know Jesus. You're saying, what are you prophesying? I am actually, because I believe that this church probably could have 3 or 4 services at one day. You know how I'm going to do it? Through the power of God. It may be creative, but God's going to do it. But we're going to ask the Lord to move upon our city. Let's pray. God, the Word of God teaches us that You have placed us in the times, in the places, for a specific purpose and reason. You chose that we would live in this area at this time. God, I pray for the 35125 and the 35135 and all of the surrounding areas, God. We pray for Pell City, Lord. There are drug addicts and alcoholics, people that even once knew Jesus that have satisfied themselves with something other than You. And I'm believing that even if it's not through this church or a person from this church, I pray that You will send people into the path of someone to give hope in life. God, I pray, Lord, for Sinclair County, Lord. I pray for Talladega County. Within a 30-mile radius, there are about 200-something thousand people that are unchurched, God. Some of them have known You before. Some are running from You. Some have never accepted You. There may be people in this church today that need to come back to You, Jesus. And I declare today is the day of salvation. God, I'm never going to be satisfied until we sow seeds all over this area, God. And I pray that You'll give creative ideas to people in this church, that You will implant and impregnate ways that we can share the good news and serve our community. God, I pray for every wayward son and daughter, every prodigal. I pray for every prodigal that is now involved in a lifestyle that is not acceptable to you. Running as hard as they can away, trying to find somebody else to attach themselves to because they have been hurt. God, I pray for people that have been hurt by churches. No church is perfect. People are not perfect. The church didn't hurt nobody, but people who were carnal and in their flesh did. And I pray that they would have mercy come upon them so that somebody that is actually being the church can reach them. God, I pray for every church in this area. I pray that you would speak to apostles and prophets and evangelists, pastors and teachers, that they will not preach in an agenda, but they would preach the word of God. God, we are better together. And I pray that you will flood every church with your presence around this area. Let them be a city on the hill, a beacon of light. God, I pray that you will raise up fathers and mothers in the faith. That exercise maturity. Who are not offended by every little thing, but who will teach not only younger people, because you don't have to be old to be a father or mother, you have to be mature in the Lord. God, I pray you will raise up generals in the faith, admirals in the faith. Some of you may say, why, that can't be me. But God, I pray, Lord, that you will expedite maturity in this church. That you will raise up disciple makers, because if people are getting led to Jesus, we need people to be able to invest in their life and teach them how to pray, study, fast, read God's word. God, I pray for the musicians on this stage, Lord. I pray that you would send even more, God, to us so the load would not be so heavy. Not just anybody, but people who understand spiritual authority and anointing. God, we're not looking for performers. We're looking for spiritually mature people that are gifted, that can cooperate with the vision of the house. God, I pray that you will impregnate every person with the vision of the house. God, I pray for every person as they leave here today, that your Holy Spirit would anoint them in such a way that when they go to restaurants and grocery stores, that they see, just like when Peter walked by a shadow healed people. God, I pray for that type of glory in our generation and even greater. Individually, God, I pray that you will enhance our awareness of your presence. Let us find you. Let us find what pleases you and what does not please you. Let us find that secret place once again. God, what would it look like if a whole entire church just throughout the week would stop and just pray? Not for what you can just do for them, but what you can do in the kingdom. Jesus prayed this way: Our Father who is in heaven, holy is your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done. God, we just want your will to be done on earth as it is in heaven. God, make this place look more like heaven every single week. Give us this day our daily bread, that's not just in the natural, but in the spiritual. God, help us through your Spirit to forgive other people. Forgive our debts as we forget those who trespass against us. For if we do not forgive other people, your word tells us our Father in heaven will not forgive us. So God, we ask for forgiveness not only in our own lives, but we forgive and we release other people to you. For yours is the kingdom. For yours is the power. For yours is the glory forever and ever. Amen and amen. Why don't we just give Jesus, come on today, give Jesus a hand clap of praise. Before the morning announcements, some of you are wondering what is in your seats. Just leave them there if you don't mind for the coming week. It's a sermon illustration. I'll preach what I was going to preach this week, next week. And in case you want to know, the scriptures are on the bulletin. I challenge you to read them this week because we're going to do something very, very unique. I won't tell you because some of you may run from the door. But it's very scriptural. And my deal is if Jesus did it, I believe we should do it. Why don't we just give the Lord a hand clap of praise today and welcome Pastor Tony for the morning announcements.
Thank you, Lord. There's a song we used to sing that says, "You're awesome in this place, mighty God." I'm telling you, isn't the Lord good, guys? Hallelujah. Won't we just give him a hand clap? Give him a praise and a shout. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, thank you. And you know this worship band, you know what they've been doing for the last hour and a half? they are doing what they're called to do, what Brother Bobby said. Thank y'all for doing what you're called to do. Y'all do it very well. Amen. They do. They do. Want God to perfect those things because he said he will perfect everything that concerns you. And you're concerned with aunts and cousins and brothers and sisters. And so, you know, during the week sometime, I do that. If you want to join me on Wednesday mornings, I start praying about 6:30. And I just sit here and I just look around and I see Lisa over here. I see it in the spirit. I see Kevin Rickles behind the drums. I see Sherry. And I'll see Bill and Gina Rogers over here, and I'll see, and I'll just say, Lord, there's got to be somebody else. Then I'll see other people, and I don't know if I get everybody's name, but I'm trying. That's why your name is so important to me. When I talk to you in the morning, I want to know, Ray, it took me 2 months to get your name, and Kathleen, it took me 2 or 3 months to get y'all's name right, but that's why I want to know it. But we have a relationship with each other that's so very, very, very important. And we can take each other to the Lord in prayer. And guys, we can have breakthrough. We can have victory. We can have revival at Harvest Center Church of God. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Pastor, for just following after the Spirit of God. Amen. He got in the game this morning, didn't he? Amen. Amen. And so thank you, first-time guests, for being here. I know that. Thank God for you. Thank you for being here today. People that joined us on Facebook from all over the world, thousands and thousands of you. Thank you for being here this morning. And but I'm not saying that jokingly. I'm just saying that. There's no telling how many people are connected with us today. Amen. There is a something that Sister Vicky, I think, is involved in called Next Steps. If you're wanting to learn more about Harvest Center, you know, just the different things, the different beliefs, the different things available for you to do at the church and the different things, the vision of the church, Sister Vicky is leading a Next Steps program that will help you out with that. you're interested in that, that's Vicki Kirby right over here. See her about that. In the mornings at 6 o'clock, I had a group of teenagers. I told the teenagers this morning that prayer is not just for adults. And prayer is not just for later in the afternoon. And 6 o'clock, guys, is not early. 6 o'clock is not early. We have prayer for Harvest Center at 6 o'clock on Monday mornings. Every Monday morning, you don't have to, you don't have to figure out when it is. It's always every Monday morning at 6 o'clock. And we are calling your name. We're believing God for you. And we want you to join in and be a part of that. So the contact information is on the wall, and I think it's in the bulletin also. So come and be a part of that on Monday morning at 6 o'clock. I think this Friday, November 18th, we're having a men's gathering, men's meeting. All the men of the church, if you're not being a part of that, we want to give a special invitation to you for that this Friday night. We always have a wonderful time. I think that Jimmy is, where are you at, Jimmy? Did I see him? Oh, he just walked out. Well, Jimmy Johnson, I think, is in responsible for the food. So, but Bobby Kay, if you want to know more information, that's that brother right back here. That's that brother right back here. Ah, la basandara yete. Ah, Jesus. Can I tell Clint something real quick? Clint, I just really, if we was having a foot washing this morning, I wanted to wash your feet, brother. I mean, I just see God moving and using you in such a powerful way. I don't believe you know the extent of your impact, but I think God is going to raise you up, and he's going to cause you to go much further than your dad thought you was going to go, much further than you ever thought you'd going to go. And, brother, I honor the call of God on your life. I honor the call of God on your life. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. The women's ministry. Tomorrow night, guys, we're going to, I've been wanting to show off my dining room table. Kevin Rickles built me a dining room table. It's an artwork. I've been wanting to show that thing off ever since we got it. So I asked Sister Tammy if, maybe she could talk with Lynn and the ladies could come to our house tomorrow night at 6:30. And she said yes, that y'all would come to our house tomorrow at 6:30. So we want to give a special invitation to all the ladies to please come and be a part of that ladies' ministry. I mean, praise and worship the Word. Fellowship is going to take place. There's no telling what might happen. I mean, the Holy Ghost might just break out right there. So just come on and be a part of that. And I don't know if this is out of place or not, but is there any ladies here that if you had a ride to tomorrow night's meeting, but you don't have a ride, if you had a ride, would you come? I don't see any hands. I was going to say if there's any hands, that somebody would be able to probably help you in that situation. But please come tomorrow night. I think directions, Tammy, do you still have directions for that to our house? It's easy to find. You can't find it with GPS, though. It's not that easy. Okay, Operation Christmas Child. This is a wonderful ministry, and I think Franklin Graham's been doing this through Samaritan's Purse for a long, long, long period of time. But Harvest Center has been involved with it in a big way, month after month after month, gathering supplies to send out as Christmas gifts to other nations, to kids around the world. And guys, it impacts families. It impacts communities. And so thank you for all that you're doing to make that successful. But sign-up sheets for those who would like to go to the main distribution center, I think it's in Atlanta, to help pack shoeboxes will be out in the foyer. The date is December the 5th. Is that for packing the boxes?
That's for going.
That's for going. Okay, that's for going. We're right now collecting small stuffed animals and balls with air pumps. And please see my sister for more. All of you is my sister, but that blood sister right there, Patty. See her for more information. On December the 2nd, on Friday night, there'll be supper here provided for everybody. That's the pack to pack, make sure all the final touches has been put on those shoe boxes to have them ready to go. Every Sunday morning at 9 o'clock, we have discipleship classes. Jesus told us to make disciples, and that's what we're trying to do. So come be a part of that. Morning worship's at 10. Thank you for all that you did today to make this service everything that it was. It's so wonderful. And, guys, all this doesn't happen. It's not free to get lights and heat and air conditioning and water and things like that. It does take money to run a ministry. So we appreciate your generosity, the way that you support the ministry of Harvest Center. There's several ways to support that. You can do it online. You can text give. You can do it by mail. But also out in the foyer, there is a black box on the left as you walk out the door. That's there for you to drop your offering in if you'd like to do that. And there's one last note. Be sure to pick up your Harvest Center event calendar for next month, because there's a lot of different things in the month of November and December. So pick up your calendar. Y'all have a great rest of the day. Thank you so much for all that you do. We love you. Praise God.